Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. We've got an update today on Bronny James going to the G League. But first, an injury update ahead of tonight's game against the Phoenix Suns. I'm Trevor Lane. Make sure you subscribe right here to the channel. Hit that subscribe button and stay up to date on all things Lakers. All right. So according to the Lakers, this was the injury report going into tonight's game. This was from last night. Jalen Huccifino listed as doubtful. The Lakers have now updated that, and Jalen Huccifino is out due to illness for tonight's game. Now, I know that most people would say, well, who cares? He's not going to be in the rotation anyway. That's true. He probably is unlikely to be available in the rotation, but this was an update directly from the Lakers, so of course we're going to share it. Jalen Huccifino officially out for tonight's game, but maybe more concerning, Jackson Hayes downgraded to probable. Now, he was not, as you can see, was not on the injury report yesterday, is dealing with left foot soreness, so he's been downgraded to probable. Now, probable obviously means he's playing, but this is something to watch. The Lakers right now, they don't have Christian Wood. They don't have Jared Vanderbilt. Christian Koloko has still not been cleared by the NBA's fitness to play panel as of this recording. So that leaves Anthony Davis and Jackson Hayes as the only two available centers on the Lakers roster. So if Jackson Hayes goes down at some point due to this left foot soreness, that could be a big problem with, well, the bigs for your Los Angeles Lakers. So again, no Jalen Huccifino tonight, but maybe a bigger thing to monitor, Jackson Hayes now dealing with a foot issue, but once again, still probable to play for tonight's game against the Phoenix Suns. All right, let's jump over to Bronny. According to Shams Charania of ESPN, the plan for Bronny is that he's going to travel with the Lakers for this upcoming road trip. Five-game road trip coming up for the Lakers. They play two more games tonight and then tomorrow, back-to-back, because thank you, NBA schedule makers, for giving the Lakers a back-to-back this early in the season. But back-to-back, we got the Suns tonight, the Kings tomorrow. Whew, that is a tough back-to-back. Suns tonight, Kings tomorrow, back-to-back. Then the Lakers head out on the road and go play in Phoenix on Monday, and then they head over to Cleveland. So Bronny is going to be part of the Lakers' upcoming road trip. He'll be there for that. But after that, he's going to report to the South Bay Lakers. So the Lakers do have this five-game road trip coming up. Not a surprise at all that Bronny is going to be doing this. In fact, this should be the expectation that he spent time in the G League. But you can see you've got Phoenix coming up on the road trip starting Monday. Phoenix, Cleveland, Toronto, Detroit, Memphis. The Lakers will return home. The G League season starts right after that game against Memphis. And then Bronny will report to the South Bay Lakers. Now, the article says shuttling back and forth. He could still come up and join the Lakers for games and things like that. But I would expect, and this I believe should always be the expectation, that Bronny James is going to spend a decent amount of time developing in the G League. This is what he needs to do. I think it's been pretty clear that he's not quite NBA caliber, but there is something there with him. We saw him play really well the end of preseason, that last game against the Golden State Warriors. I thought he had his best game as a Laker. He needs time to develop, and so that's exactly what he's going to do with the South Bay Lakers, which again, should have always been the expectation. I know people are going to make a lot of this and say, oh my gosh, Bronny, he can't even stay on the team. He's going to be in the G League, all that. This is the norm in today's NBA. I know not a lot of people pay attention to the G League, but for second-round picks, this is what happens to second rounders. Maxwell Lewis spent time in the G League last year. Hell, Alex Caruso has created an incredible NBA career after spending time in the G League. So this is a very normal thing for second round picks, and Bronny is going to be playing a lot with the South Bay Lakers. Now, it's possible that we see him very, very little, if at all, with the Lakers from here on out with the big team here, just because he's going to be developing with South Bay. And aside from garbage time, I don't think he's ready to be put in an NBA game right now. And once again, nor should that be the expectation. Now, that said, if you want to go check out over on BetUS, Bronny James still a plus 20,000 to win Rookie of the Year. I mean, let's just be real. He was never going to win Rookie of the Year to begin with. He's certainly not going to win Rookie of the Year if you're in the G League. I mean, look, in order to win Rookie of the Year, you have to be on the floor. That's the biggest thing. It's opportunity. We may not see Bronny play for the Lakers again. Maybe he gets in a few garbage time situations, but that's probably going to be it. But nonetheless, plus 20,000 is pretty crazy odds. I'm sure some people are still taking flyers on it. I saw he was one of the most betted players, but plus 20,000 to win Rookie of the Year. Again, it's not going to happen, but that's what's out there right now. If you guys want to check it out over on BetUS, you certainly can. They do have a fantastic deal right now. 150% sign up bonus on your first deposit, 125% bonus on your next two, up to $2,000 using our promo code Lakers Nation. So go check that out. Again, I'm not expecting Bronny James to win Rookie of the Year, and the expectation should always be that he was going to spend time in the G League developing, getting ready to eventually grow into an NBA player. That's the goal right now for Bronny. So good to hear that that is indeed going to be the plan, and he'll spend time in the G League. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Bronny James down to the South Bay Lakers, just like we thought. Is this a negative for the Lakers? How do you see this? I think the biggest issue is that he is still taking up a full roster spot, and that's been the bigger problem. More so than drafting Bronny with the 55th pick, it's been the roster spot, because there have been opportunities they've missed due to the lack of having a roster spot available. But you guys, let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Till next time, everybody. See ya, and stay safe.